Hi everybody, 58th issue of your magazine AfroBasket. We'll be back right after the summary. One year after organizing AfroBasket, what happens to Ivory on basketball? Diagnosis through the championship. Two brand new stadium. Zach is the legacy bequeathed to Ivory on basketball to Abidjan 2013 AfroBasket. We recall that previously the championship was held outdoor at Lycée Classique and Modern of Trècheville. With these facilities, the Ivorian Federation basketball has a real challenge to take up.
Donc la fois nous a permis d'avoir des salles.
Nous a permis. Let's say that AfroBasket has allowed us to have sports hall. AfroBasket also allowed us to have in terms of events, expertise, event management, but has not yet been directly implemented what we tend. In any case, it belongs to an education, a discipline. At first, it was hard, but we reached there. We barely play every day of the week. And all this is due to AfroBasket, which enabled us to support this race. AfroBasket left us a legacy that is hard to take. A real timetable has been established by the Ivorian Basketball Federation, which only aim is the practice of orange ball. A real timetable has been established by the Ivorian Basketball Federation, which only aim is the practice of the orange ball. The side of the federation, they want to go too fast. Listen to the programming.
On dit, après les préliminaires, on prend les six premiers de la poule A. Ils sont déjà qualifiés pour le top 10. Maintenant, il va falloir chercher les quatre autres places. Les quatre autres places seront disputées entre les six derniers de la poule A et les dix premiers de la fusion B et C.
It is said after the preliminary, we take the first six of group A already qualified for the top 10. The other 10 will take place between group A remaining six and the first 10 after merging B and C groups, which makes 16 teams that will make the preliminaries in back-to-back opposition. There will be winners and losers. Winners team being the race to reach the top six, and the loser will play rankings because we must set the ranking to know who is who. Now there is another chance in the second phase. We take the top 10 8, who will play the final over the first six who will play the play.
Ils vont jouer les playoffs.
Do you understand? It's what we have to set up here. Understood or not understood, they must get that. They expect to be in the top 10, they must play hard. Those who will follow after will compete in N1 and the others in N2. That's it. Even if they have trouble accepting it, they are already engaged in competition, so they must go through. Today, we are seeking no more for understanding, we seek to be in the top 10. Eventually, we realize that after the preliminaries, 10 teams will be selected for the top 10 to play in the professional league in 2015. The next 10 in N1 and the remains in N2. However, after those two phases, ABC, GC and Azur led the championship. After the pick and roll, place for an introduction to various forms of attacks.
Vous après, c'est vous qui prenez la place ici. Hein? Pour le moment, on fait juste le plus simple. C'est du 1 contre 1. Il n'y a pas d'aide, donc il va être obligé de tirer. Okay? Il est tout seul, il va être obligé de tirer. Donc là, c'est juste un rapport de force entre lui et lui. Si lui, il est meilleur, il va marquer. Si lui, il est meilleur, il ne va pas marquer. Ballon, va le chercher, demande-le. Allez, il faut l'attaquer. Allez, et rebond encore. Très bien. C'est important, meneur de jeu, va pas. Le ballon, tu vas le récupérer ici. Plein milieu, je ne vais pas récupérer le ballon. Le meneur de jeu, tu récupères le ballon là. La plupart du temps, tu seras ici, là. Et ok, et là tu vas pouvoir jouer à droite, à gauche où tu veux. Allez, changez toujours, vous êtes 13. Allez, agressif, agressif. Ok, ok, bonne défense. Allez, agressif. Ok, c'est bien l'attaque, c'est bien la défense. Panier, vous faites remise en jeu et les deux rouges, vous attaquez ici. S'il n'y a pas panier, voilà, il faut impérativement marquer les deux rouges. Ok, on va là et on vient là. S'il y a panier, il y a remise en jeu. S'il n'y a pas panier, battez-vous, revenez marquer le panier ici. Normalement, les blancs, vous devez toujours marquer. Deux contre un, vous devez marquer. Attention, il faut aller vite parce que lui, il revient derrière. Hein. Sur lui, hein, il ne peut pas revenir ce joueur-là, c'est pas possible. Ok, vous ne devez pas perdre l'avantage, il faut courir. Allez, il faut courir. Allez, deux, bien. Allez, deux contre un. Perdu l'avantage encore. Regarde, on plie maintenant. Allez, il faut le mettre. Allez. Bien, les blancs. Hop, 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 hop. Allez, il est loin. Allez, il est loin. Bien joué. Bien joué, les rouges. Empêchez de marquer, les rouges. Oh là là, oh là là. Contrôlez sans faire de faute, sans faire de faute. Sans faire de faute, vous êtes trois. Jouer, il a deux pivots qui sont un peu en bas. Ok, pensez bien, vous, impérativement, vous avez un gros rôle. S'il y a deux en bas, s'il rentre un peu ce qui se passe là, voilà, il faut absolument revenir derrière lui. Ok, et toi, s'il rentre un peu là, il faut revenir un peu derrière lui pour être prêt à rejouer. Et tous les deux, ben, restez un peu en bas et puis vous voyez ce qui se passe. Vous restez dans le secteur. Ça joue, vous perdez d'un point les blancs. Ça joue les blancs, ça joue les blancs, vous perdez trois points les blancs. Jouez, jouez les blancs, jouez, jouez. Jouez, jouez là, vous perdez 3 points, jouez! Laisse le chrono, jouez, défense les rouges! Vous gagnez 3 points les rouges, vous gagnez 3 points! Ok, 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 voilà! Match nul!
I invite you to discover in a quick view everything that has made the African basketball news. After his victory over the Primorro de Agosto, 78-77, Recreativo do Líbano was offered the title of Angola Senior Man Champion. 2 games from the Final Four, Líbano is already champion with 19 points while Primorro de Agosto is second with 16 points. Although do Líbano loses its last 2 games, it will always lead with 21 points, a score that no other 3 teams participating in the tournament can reach. Senior women team Primero de Agosto won last May in Luanda the Angolan National Championship with a victory over Interclube 68-47. Interclube was the holder of the trophy. The two clubs will represent Angola at Zone 6 Club Champion 24 playoffs. African club won the 2013-24 Tunisian Basketball Championship. After beating Étoile Sportive du Sahel on the score of 73-63, halftime 31-77, in the game to support the final play Saturday, May 24 at Sousse Hall. Club African won the second title of its history, dethroning Étoile Sportive du Sahel, trip holder of the trophy. Training Saint-Etienne, and more precisely at Colomiers, and after playing in Italy, Mike Mokongo has been crowned NM1 France champion, the equivalent of the third division with Monaco. Who is that Central African Republic player who never missed the call of Wildcats? Portrait.
Mais sinon, j'ai commencé le basketball à l'âge de 7 ans de mon pays d'origine, à Centrafrique. Quand mon papa était parti au jeu 92 à Barcelone, et il avait instauré un panier de basketball à la maison. Et puis bon, c'est là que j'ai
commencé. J'ai basketball à l'âge de 7 ans dans mon home country, Central Africa Republic,
quand
mon dad went à Barcelone en 92 Olympic Games. On his return, he set up a basketball group at home and it was my debut. Once in France, I continued and I became professional. I arrived very early and I integrated INSEP, where there are all the best young French players. Then I joined l'ANCHESEN and immediately they spotted my talent. So my president decided to make me take French nationality. I've integrated France national team and I play in the youth category. It must be said that the arrival of Tony Parker did not help me, but mostly all over things like family pressure, knowing that I started at home. And my parents have always wanted me to play for Central African Republic team, so I opted for my country. Playing for France would not have been the same, and also it's always better to play for his home country. And today, I don't regret my decision, and I'm glad to be here. African Cup competition has become a very, very tough one. Players need to prepare sooner. They need to train together, and the Federation are still struggling to gather the players as soon as possible. To set mechanisms and have a coach who can make the team go forward. When you have a player like Romain Sato playing in EuroLeague and which is not in the national team, it's disappointing for us. I think it's important to know the direction you want to go. All actors, state, federation, and even the players are
duty.
Everyone should look in the mirror and find what to do to make the Central African Republic basketball advance. Since a very young age, my dream has always been to enter the NBA. I tried body and soul to make it, but God refused. On the other side, I've played this quite good championship
in France, Spain, and Turkey.
But today, I need stability in my life at the age of 27. I think the economic stability of a country guarantees a good championship, so I know I have to stay in France. Everyone remembers the generation of Lavorma and Goporo, who won the last CAN in 1987. You know, in sports, there is no secret. Today, Central African Republic has deeply failed at the country structure in relation to infrastructure. And I really like to give back to the Central African Republic basketball what it gave me. Get back and try to set basketball camps and structure projects. To create structures in order to help my country basketball evolve. Have camps that allow me to bring friends from NBA and Europe to try to make the Central African children dreaming. Because we really need it here.
En Europe pour essayer de faire rêver les jeunes centrafricains afin qu'ils puissent voir des grands joueurs parce que on a vraiment besoin de ça chez nous.
Here is the end of this 58th issue. Let's meet back for the 59th. Take care.